It's the big one here at York. It's the 1 mile, 6 furlong Ebor handicap for horses rated up to 120. £1 million on offer here. Denver Baraka for Vinnie Gerard. Last Samurai for Ryan Tamasebi. Short in the betting, but high in the weights. Cool Minx Rosie for Darren Thompson. Foxy, Michael Scala, Heshan Luda, Vinnie Gerard. Birthplace, Graham Clutterbuck. Quattro Catch, James Shea. Jammer Cottage, James Shea. No More Promises, David Hooley. Deal of the Day, Craig Beckwith. Crafty Salam, Steve Rann. Prim and Proper, Ryan Tamasebi. Jinga Bruer, Steve Rann. Bronze Demon, Paul Rhodes. Dazzy Bally, Dan Hughes. Pitch Perfect, Graham Clutterbuck. Catherine Nini, the favourite for Satyam. Yakuta Pandora, Alex Ince. What You're Proposing, Padraig Hogan. Chariot Charger, Alex Cherry. Fortune Winner, David Hooley. And Set Menu for Martin Leedham. That completes your lineup for the Ebor. And they are off and running in the big one here at York. Good even break, but it's Quattro Catch that's gone out into that early lead. But you can see Catherine Nini, the favourite. Another one of Satyam's front runners. He's been the master at placing his horses in handicaps, particularly over the past few weeks, landing prize after prize. And Catherine Nini, the money's down on this one to land another big prize for Satyam. Potentially the biggest prize of all for him in the Ebor. And it opens up a good length or two advantage over Quattro Catch, Chariot Charger and Pitch Perfect. But they've all now reduced that advantage and about within around a length of the leader, the grey horse Catherine Nini. We've got Chariot Charger alongside that one is Birthplace. And in behind those, Fortune Winner in the all purple silks just looking towards the rear of the field. We've got Cool Minx Rosie, Heshan Luda, Foxy, Bronze Demons currently, one of the back markers for Paul Rhodes. And Jinka Bruer, the grey horse in the Khaled Abdullah colours, is racing very wide on the track at the moment as we have 9 furlongs left to go and they're just starting to swing left-handed there. Some of these horses racing very far wide. That could be due to the large field wanting to avoid traffic problems or just trying to get a bit of the quicker ground. Just having a look at some of the shorter prices in the betting. We've got Denver Baraka and Last Samurai currently racing towards the middle and rear of the field. Last Samurai is just in the red and blue towards the middle of that pack alongside Dazzy Bally, one of the grey horses in the race. And Denver Baraka is currently racing in the all green silks towards the rear of the field at the moment. So two of those, the highest rated horses in the field, but also fancied in the betting to try and make light of that top weight and still manage to pick up this big prize. But as we hit the 5 furlong marker, it's still Catherine Nini in the lead. You can see Last Samurai has come out really wide as we come around that bend to avoid any traffic problems. Pitch Perfect is in second currently in behind Catherine Nini. Last Samurai's moved up smoothly alongside Quattro Catch. Dazzy Bally the Grey's there. Crafty Salam on the outside of that one. Jinka Bruer still racing wide but trying to get going down the wide outside and passing Fortune Winner. So there's plenty in with a chance here as we come inside the final 3 furlongs in the Ebor, and it's still the favourite, Catherine Nini, trying to hold off all challenges. Dazzy Bally now moves forward. Deal of the Day is over on the towards the rail. Quattro Catch moving forward. Prim and Proper's now moved forward, but is already now starting to fade. Last Samurai, the stablemate of that one, passes it. Denver Baraka, the favourite, has now come from absolutely nowhere to move forward into second, but it's still Catherine Nini that they all have to catch as we come inside the final furlong. Pitch Perfect's coming. Cool Minx Rosie's burst out of the pack. Last Samurai staying on. Birthplace is staying on down the wide outside, but it's that stablemate of Birthplace, Pitch Perfect, that takes the Ebor. Pitch Perfect raced handy just off the pace for the majority of the race, and as Catherine Nini's challenge faded towards the end of the race, Pitch Perfect was there with perfect timing to take up the running and burst clear to win the Ebor. Cool Minx Rosie with a really good ride, stayed on really well for Darren Thompson and looked to win a half a furlong from home. Catherine Nini had nothing left to give, but still got good prize money there in third place for Satyam in third. Birthplace completes a 1-4 for Graham Clutterbuck. He'll be delighted with that outcome. And Last Samurai stayed on to take fifth place off a high weight. But a win in the Ebor for Pitch Perfect and Graham Clutterbuck.